Brad Hamblen with Cardinal Financial, and you're watching the right video if you want to learn more about how mortgage insurance works or PMI works. So mortgage insurance, PMI, first off, mortgage insurance is what insures the loan if you don't have 20% to put down on a conventional loan. We're not going to talk about mortgage insurance for FHA loans or USDA loans right now. We're just going to talk about conventional loans. So if you're doing a 3, 5, 10, 15% down loan program, there's different mortgage insurance options for you. So PMI, what is PMI? Private mortgage insurance. So private mortgage insurance is a company that actually insures the down payment that you're not putting down. So if something happens and the loan goes into the default, and when it's defaulted on, the bank gets paid the full amount that they're owed because there's an insurance policy that covers the amount all the way to the 20%. So to give you an example, you put down 5%, so you have 15% of the 20% that you did not put down. So there's an insurance policy on that 15%. So if you default, that 15% gets paid to the lender. So the insurance policies are based off of how much money you borrow, and the insurance PMI premiums are less the more you put down. So if you put down 5% versus 10% versus 15%, the PMI is gonna go down at each one of those levels, and it's at 5% increments. So there's three different ways that mortgage insurance can be handled. So the first one is the typical, which most people follow, which is borrower paid monthly mortgage insurance. This means every month you have to pay mortgage insurance or PMI in your payment. So there's another way that that can be handled. So you can actually handle it by paying a single premium upfront. Well, when it comes to like collecting the money for the PMI, depending on how much money you're putting down, you can pay a percentage of the loan amount and you can buy out the PMI at the beginning. Now, this is a good strategy if you're looking to be in the home long term, but and you're gonna plan on keeping the loan. But if something were to happen and you refinance it at the beginning stages, or you sell the property at the beginning stages, you may end up losing some money because there's a hard investment up front. Another option, this would be the another option that you would have, is if you do an interest rate increase where the single premium is paid by the interest rate that's chosen. So to give you an example, if today's rates were at 3% and you took a rate that was at 3.25%, that difference that you have there could actually buy out the premium for the mortgage insurance. It's not necessarily gonna be 0.25%, it depends on what the costs are, but again, it's just giving you an example. So you end up with a little bit of a higher interest rate, but you don't have mortgage insurance. So when you look at these options, you really have to determine what best fits your scenario. So it's really a personal decision. It's not going to have a big impact on you one way or the other, but there's three different options for you. If you have more questions about how mortgage insurance works or PMI, feel free to email me or give me a call. Look forward to hearing from you. Have a great day.